Looks like some drastic cuts could be on the way for Anne Arundel County school children and employees. That's the word tonight from the school superintendent, who says he's prepared to cut as much as $15 million Wow. from next year's budget.
And it turns out that layoffs and furloughs are not out of the question. 11 News education reporter Tim Tootin is live in the 11 newsroom with more on that story. Tim.
Well, Donna, this is a very gloomy budget forecast, and it comes on the heels of a meeting a few days ago between the school superintendent and the county executive.
School officials say no program is off limits, even those which support the classroom. But they fear the biggest cuts will be made to staff, which make up more than 80% of the operating budget.
We can't make that kind of a cut without touching people and certainly without touching programs. So we're keeping all of our options open. We're looking at every single department, every single program, to see where we can come up with this money if it comes to pass.
Cutting staff members, especially those who deliver instruction, would lead to larger class sizes. And that may not set well with some Anne Arundel County parents.
I think it's pretty dangerous right now because you never know, you know, where the cuts are going to be. And right now they don't have many teachers for enough classes anyway.
For now, there may be few options. In a memo from the school superintendent to principals and top staff members, he warned that furloughs and layoffs were real possibilities and that impacting present employees is all but unavoidable. The proposed cuts could start at headquarters before reaching schools and critical programs which affect children.
I think that we need to all work together to figure out ways that we can support our children in and outside of school. But I think that where there is money, we need to make sure that education is not the place where we make those drastic cuts, because that is our future.
Members of the school board are expected to lead the charge to try and change the minds of the county executive and county council.
Now, County Executive John Leopold tells 11 News that he plans to increase the education budget this year, but he says funding pay increases for teachers, staff, and administrators is unsustainable in this economy. Live in the 11 Newsroom, Tim Tootin, WBAL-TV 11 News.